Steph Curry, Jordan Poole will get the start in the backcourt. Klay Thompson out tonight, injury rehab. Andrew Wiggins alongside Otto Porter Jr. and Kevon Looney. For the Utah Jazz, Conley and Mitchell up front. Royce O'Neal, Bogey, and Dope Azubuike.
But three games in four nights for the Warriors starts tonight. Five games in five different cities. Looney, a little show and go. And all the Azubuike struggle defensively. Good to see Otto Porter Jr. and Looney in the lineup, because the Warriors had a chance to be really small tonight if they had to sit out. Otto eases into a three. Andrew Wiggins, the right side. It's left or right for the all-star Andrew Wiggins. Curry waiting for Porter and floating it over Azubuike. And this is a wonderful beginning for the Dubs.
As far as I'm concerned.
And he's always been a good defender on Steph. Looney knocked him off with the screen. Finds an Otto Porter three wide open.
He knows he can get by his guy, his main defender right in front of him. But he's usually focused on the guys behind him. And when you're playing against the Warriors, when they're whole, as Steph knocks down a little mid-range jumper, kiss off the glass.
It should be a tough cover for Hassan Whiteside guarding him.
Wiggins getting downhill. Look, Kuminga's not even being guarded there. JTA, a little interchange. Again, Whiteside's not going to come out on shooters. So the Warriors, a lot of drawn kicks. And Kuminga, another three.
He's been assertive at the right time. He definitely get to the basket.
Another quality Florida State guy. Played all 4 years there. And JTA flipping it up and in.
You and your word, Fanny.
What do you want me to say? Hey,
there's plenty of words.
Right. Jordan Poole in the three.
You can go with booty if you want.
All right. A little draw and kick out to JTA. Missing that three, but Poole, the teardrop follow. I don't know that Jordan Clarkson can stay with Steph, and so I think this is an opportunity for Curry. Jordan Poole, the leading scorer in the game, has 13. It's the big number, 10-0 in points off turnovers. Utah doesn't give it away. When the Warriors do, they hurt them, as Wiggins dropping in a triple. Wiggins, nice skip pass, and Looney the good screen. That's beautifully done. Andrew Wiggins, you need a big second half on the floater. Jordan Poole catch and shoot three. Perfectly done off an Andrew Wiggins creation. So GP2 and Damian Lee. Now the Warrior bench is only 3 of 14 shooting. They need some reserve scoring here.
And the Jazz bench has been really good.
That's been the problem. Wiggins, what a finish there. I see Kuminga there. They're giving him the three, but that is a great dunk.
Watch two defenders stay with the ball handler.
D. Lee and Poole, Moody, GP2 and JTA. And Jordan Poole putting it up and in. Because everyone was so disappointed in that game. And that's when Draymond really kind of gave the speech at a film session, and they reeled off a 9-game winning streak. You have a chance to beat anybody.
And Anthony Davis has been playing well.
Moody from the foul line and then rimmed that in. JTA rainbowing in that three. The defense is something you still want to keep showing the coaches, and Utah's kind of taking it to them in the second half.
I'm just impressed with Juan Toscano-Anderson knocking down that three and shooting another one.
There you go. JTA hitting a couple. So for the Warriors, Knicks, and JTA hits another three. Can there be 15, 20 games of that?
Problems for the opponents, that's what'll happen.
I mean, they're problems for the opponents all through the year with the second best record in the league.
Yeah,
it's life in the NBA.
And this last stretch, that's been their mentality. Let's go out with who we got, we're all we got.
For the Warriors, the 9-game winning streak comes to an end. And they will go to 41-14, 16-10 on the road. But come home for two in a row, finally. After tomorrow, six games in six different cities. The final score, 111-85.